So one of the best things about being in between projects is that it means I have an opportunity to come down and make some improvements here in the workshop to get myself ready for that new project to start. So let's talk today about something we're doing for this brand new sharpening station.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop, sponsored by
MicroJig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
And by Centipede Tool, manufacturer of the Centipede Portable Work System, the ultimate in portable work support. For more information, visit centipedetool.com.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning of the episode, we're in between projects, and this is an opportunity that I usually like to take for myself to, say, either clean up the shop or maybe work on a project that's kind of been one of those things in the back of my mind. Perhaps as I was working on a previous project, there was something that just kind of didn't quite go as well as it could have, so this might be the perfect time to come in and try and fix that. And the thing that has really been bugging me for a long, long time has been my sharpening station. And in fact, I kind of have a new one. Really what I did is I commandeered this from the family. It's always kind of been sitting out on our back deck area. It's a three-season porch, and it's never really been used all that often. When Sam and I were first moving in together, we had this, and it worked great for the tiny kitchen that we had, but once we got to our new place, it just kind of got set aside. I'm sure many of you probably have pieces of furniture very much like that. Now, one thing that I like about this particular piece of furniture and using it for the sharpening station is that it has a lot of benefits. Now, perhaps you might remember my original sharpening station, which we'll try and get a better look at this, but you can kind of get a feel for it. The main thing with this is while this roll around cart worked for years as a really good sharpening area, one, the surface space just ended up being a little bit too small. Perhaps if I didn't have the Tormek and just simply just use the stones, or vice versa, maybe if I got rid of the stones and just simply use the Tormek, this probably would have worked out perfectly. But as it was, I like to use both of them and to have them readily available, and therefore it kind of got a little cramped. The other thing that I don't really like about this, and you can notice this right away, look at the surface top on this. It's much higher up than this one. So what this really does for me is the fact that when I am, say, using those stones, I'm not so hunched over and potentially, you know, kind of hurting my back. Because let's get serious, depending on how bad of a nick you have in a blade or something, this right here, this motion, this way of having your body posture just really is not very comfortable. Where this, and we'll see this in just a second, this is much higher up. I am noticing already, I feel like my elbows are coming up a little bit, but it really does kind of give me a better sense of control and a better posture when I'm doing it. And that's really, really important. Now, another reason why I'm really kind of happy to be getting rid of this is because of the fact that it's a roll around. I probably could have chalked the tire somehow, put a little something on there to stop them, a block or something. But even if I had done that, oftentimes what I have to do is kind of come in and I'll have to put my knee up against the front rail here and hold it in position and kind of push it up against the wall in order to get really good honing action from this, or be able to do really good honing action, because it definitely was rocking around quite a bit. So that got to be really tiring, and that's why I have no problem pushing this out of the way and therefore going with this station. Now, the big thing that I want to accomplish today is I want to have an area for the stones, because on that other one thing I had a problem with was as I was honing on the stones, they would kind of, depending on where I was, I might have to chase them just a little bit. I think we're all familiar with this. So what I'm going to do is set up this little area here where I can actually kind of trap the stones in there and then just go to town on it. So let's go ahead and take a look at this right now and how we're going to make this little improvement on this workstation. So really, this is probably the one thing I am most excited about. The surface space is just fantastic. The height is really amazing. But the fact that I'm going to create this little spot for the stones has me like geeked out the most, because this means I can really put these in there and not chase it all over the place. So what I ended up doing here, just to let you have an idea of the materials I have, I went with a piece of galvanized steel that I picked up at my local home center. Originally, I was thinking of going with something like some tin, because we actually have some old tin signs that are around. And one thing I liked about them was they had a little bit of a lip, so if there's water, it's going to kind of catch it and won't go all over the place. With this, I don't have that, but I'm not really too concerned about it, because while the stones get a little messy, they don't get that messy that I can't simply come in and clean them up afterwards. Anyways, what I ended up doing was taking some scrap maple that I had left over, and the key was to make sure that the whatever scrap I ended up using here was thinner than the stone itself, because I don't want anything interfering with the actual motion I'm be doing here. So once I cut the scrap pieces to the width that I needed to make sure that the steel plate was in place, I then just came in with some stainless steel screws and I pre-drilled for those. I then drove them into position using some stainless steel finish washers. And once I had the first corner done, I just simply made sure everything was clamped nice and tight and repeated it on the other side. So that's where we are right now. We're going to go ahead and we're going to attach the other piece of scrap at the top, again, to make sure that this fits right in here very nicely and I don't have to chase it all over the place. And the way that I'm going to end up doing that is, these shaped in stones are the ones that I'm going to be using pretty much all the time. I have a 1,000 and a 4,000, and maybe someday I'll end up picking up a much higher grip, but these work out really good for what I want to do. And to figure out exactly where I want this piece, I'm going to use the stones as my guide. So we're going to do a little bit of relative dimensioning in here. And all I'm going to do is rest this up against the bottom. I'm then going to take a pencil and I'm just going to kind of run this along here. And you can kind of see I'm pulling this along the edge. And what it's doing is it's going to give me a pencil line up here at the very top that I know I can then take this piece of scrap, line it up with that pencil line, and there, so we got that in position. That's pretty good, and it's a little snug, so I must have done something slightly wrong. Maybe when I was holding it in place just now, I pushed it forward. All right, so let's try that. There we go. So it might have a little play in it, but I'm not worried about it because I'm not chasing it all over the place. That's going to work out awesome. So now that I have an idea of where that's going to go, we are going to come back in here and we're going to repeat the process that we did down here up at the top. So as you can see, attaching the plate itself was really simple, and adding these, I don't know what we call them, bumper strips or something, is even easier. Now, one thing I did do, and we do this quite frequently here in the basement workshops, we have a little design change on the fly. Now, one thing I was concerned about as I was looking at this more is, let's say I do have the stone kind of centered in here and I'm pushing some pressure, I'm afraid that these strips might actually flex slightly since they're so thin. So I went ahead and added another set of screws, one at the top and one at the bottom, to ensure that there's no major flexing or potential breaking of those strips in that area. Another thing I did, and this was totally last second, as I mentioned, I usually like to use just the shaft and stones. That's what I've been going to quite frequently, more and more. But I also still have my old water stones. And with these higher grit water stones, they actually have this base on them that is much longer than the shaft and stones. I mean, not really much longer, just slightly. And the problem is they didn't fit within here. So I was concerned that as I was bringing it back, it might flex or have an issue. So I added yet again another strip that will actually pinch the base right here, the foot in the front, so that it doesn't move back and forth significantly as I'm using it. So we pretty much used the very similar technique to get this attached. The only problem is I didn't have any more of these finish washers, so I'm going to have to go out and get some because they just don't look the same. I want everything to have that really beautiful uniform look, even though it is a utilitarian piece. Now, I do have some other lower grit water stones, and they actually fit in here rather nicely. They're a little bit shorter than the shaft and stones, but it's going to work out great. So anyways, we have this all taken care of, and now I have a little home for my stones so that they're not going to go all over the place when I come in to do my honing action. So now that I got everything in place here, it's time to just do a little bit of honing, and let's see what we have. Oh, well, that's so nice. So if you have comments, questions, suggestions, you know how to get a hold of me. You can email me at mattspaceworkshop@gmail.com. And of course, you can leave a comment in the show notes for today's episode. And if you're watching this over at YouTube, you can leave a comment over there. I love hearing from all of you. So until the next time, I'm just going to be sitting here loving every second of how comfortable and awesome this new sharpening station is. Until then, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. Also, please consider becoming a patron of Matt's Basement Workshop. get early access to new shows, bonus content from each episode, and so much more. Visit patreon.com/Matt's Basement Workshop to sign up and start receiving your benefits today.